I start, as you can hear me, I will make the same request again and again. I'm not shy about it. So take your devices out, take all your devices out that you communicate with, phones, time to silence, please. Not vibrate, not lower volume, silence. And do me a big favor, especially my younger brothers and sisters. Don't bring into the master the 20 minutes that you're here. I can guarantee that you're not on call. I guarantee you're not on call. So don't bring it to the master. Make a habit out of it, okay? So that we're right. In alhamdulillah. Certainly, without a doubt, all praise, thanks, gratitude belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nahmuduhu, for that reason, we praise Him. We thank Him for everything He has given to us. We thank Him for this beautiful day. We thank Him for the opportunity that you have, that you came here to pray, to praise Him. ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. الله says in his book, قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا أو believers اتقوا الله. Be mindful of Allah. Be conscious of Allah. Know the presence of Allah at all the time. Be mindful. Be watchful. Fear that you will disappoint Him. Be mindful. حق قتاله the way he deserves it. ولا تموتن under no circumstance. Don't you dare forget this rule we just mentioned, that you need to attain consciousness of Allah. إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Unless that you are in a full state of submission. So you're regularly khatib, couldn't make it, he actually got called for another khutbah somewhere else, and we just back up to the backup. I'm going to just say a couple of words here. None of them should be new to you. The idea of khutbah is not to introduce you to something new, but rather to remind you of what you already know. That is the purpose of khutbah, a reminder. Okay? That's what I'm trying to do, inshallah. And here's the thing that I've been harping on. Here's the thing that I've been mentioning every single time that I stand here. The month that you and I went through, the month of Ramadan that passed, that month is about one thing. Many other things are associated with it. There's one thing, is this. The month of Quran. That means we had to do things to come close to this Quran. That means we had to learn something from it. So I'm going to mention a few ayat. Just as an exercise, that what are we trying to do? What are you learning from this book? After all, you and I said this book is a guidance for us. We accepted that. That means now we need to explore upon this. So there's an ayah in the Quran, in Surah Al-Ali Imran, the third surah. Allah says the following. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم والله غفور رحيم. One thing that I mentioned a few times in Ramadan, and I didn't go far enough. It was purposely mentioned that way, and I was thinking about it for the last few days, and actually feeling guilty. Whenever you do something, Allah gives you an incentive to do so. And here's a couple of incentives here in this ayah that I recited, and I'm going to give you the translation in a minute. But these incentives are not the end. They're just the means to make you move forward. And that is the point that I failed to mention during Ramadan and a couple of other khutbahs that I was doing. So the homework for you is, I'm not giving you the answer. You probably hate me because I'm doing my khutbahs, I give you homework. Why? What is the purpose? I'm just being silly. The purpose is for you to ponder, to think, to take something with you, and you have further opportunities to discuss this. So the homework for you is, if the incentive is not the end for me, what is the end? What is the ultimate goal? What am I talking about? Here's one incentive. Allah says, who these is, you're going to get jannat and tajim and tahiyya al-anhar. You get garments. You're going to get jannah. Is jannah the ultimate goal, or is there something else? That is your homework to figure this out. So Allah says in this ayah, قُلْ say, in an address to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by default, in an address to all of you, me and you included. By the way, I'm going to do one thing here during this khutbah. The purpose is not to offend you. The purpose is just to say you. Same thing as Sheikh Bakri says when he explained that he actually says you, addressing all of you. So instead of talking in the third person, I'm really mentioning you. So don't be offended. I'm not trying to put anyone down or anything. So for Allah, Allah says, O Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say. Say what? In kuntum tuhibbun Allah, if you are serious about loving Allah, if you really mean it, and if you have structured your life in a way that you think you got to the point that you can claim now that you could fall in love with God and Allah, then what you should do? فَاتَّبِعُونِي, then follow me. Allah says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to say that to everyone. And now you're hearing this. If you really, truly understood that how you can fall in love with God, with Allah, then follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ittaba in Arabic means to follow lovingly, to follow willingly, to follow with wholeheartedly, not just to follow. The translation says follow, it's really injustice to the translation. Follow lovingly. Well, what does that mean? There are two contexts. If you look into the Sira context, it's a completely different story, but what does it mean to you and I today? How do you follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? That being the precondition for loving Allah. Let's talk about actually loving. How do you really fall in love with something or someone? It's not a trick question. Think about it. The more you get to know someone, the more time you spend, the more you become interested, the more you're going to know about that person. Just think about friendships. Think about who's your best friend. The more you are in touch with that person, the more you are actually closer and in love with the person. So there's another ayah for Quran. I'm going to translate that for you. Ittabi'uni, to follow me lovingly, is being given further evidence in other part of the Quran. And Allah says this, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ. So listen to these words carefully, please. These words are powerful. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Allah speaking an oath, so the first thing you have to understand, when Allah is saying, I swear by something, it is powerful. In this case, Allah says, I swear by your God, by your master, by your Lord, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ. He's taking an oath, Allah is taking an oath on himself by addressing Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, I take an oath by your Lord, by your master, by your God. For what? What is this oath taking for? لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. It's kind of scary. You all will not believe. What does that mean, you don't believe? You don't have faith. You don't believe. Why? Until all of you, us, make Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as judge, make him judge based on what we are disputing. Pause a second. Anytime you and I are facing an issue, a challenge, if we do not reach out to the book of Allah and the prophetic tradition to get lessons, to get answers from that, if you and I have done it, Allah says, you do not believe. That's it, period. حتى يحكم فيما شجر بينهم and here's a condition ثم لا يجد في أنفسهم حرجا. When you seek an answer from prophetic tradition for one of the challenges that you're facing, and this is your condition should look like, ثم لا يجد, you do not find the slightest, this the most insignificant heart, trouble in your heart to accept it, to believe it. You don't have even a smallest hesitation. So why Allah says this, and why? Look at our condition. I hate to be negative in that. Anytime you and I ask for a response to something, we ask the person who's giving khutbah, the person who's giving a lecture, and we kind of don't like the answer. Our immediate default answer is like, well, there are differences of opinion, right? Meaning, I'm looking for a loophole, meaning I'm looking for a standard line. I want to find an answer until I am satisfied with that answer. Allah says, don't you have a single shred of hesitation in your heart when you're looking for an answer from prophetic tradition that you were seeking. Going back to the ayah we just recited, if you want to fall in love, this was the translation of how to follow the Prophet ﷺ. What is the incentive for falling in love with the Prophet ﷺ? What is the incentive for falling in love with God? Here's what Allah says. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. This is heavy, brothers, sisters, my younger brothers, sisters, all of you. Listen carefully. This is incredibly heavy. Allah says, if you do this, Allah will love you back. What else is there? If Allah, the one who created you and I, the one who provides you every single thing, all the opportunities that you have in life, is only and only one reason, because He is the one who grants you that. On top of those opportunities, He's saying He will love you back. You can't find any better than that. You cannot find anything better than that. On top of it, Allah says, if that's not good enough for you, where are Allah will forgive anything that you have done. Completely wipe it clean, anything that you have done. So long as you're sincere, so long as you follow the prophetic tradition, so long as you are sincere. Wallahu ghafurur rahim. Allah is extremely forgiving. Allah is extremely merciful. Here's a little nuance in Arabic. Usually when you read the end of ayah, usually it's called something like Inna Allah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, right? The Inna part is missing here. Why do you think it's missing? These are the kind of reflections Allah is telling you and I when we read Quran to reflect upon. Inna shows certainty, whatever that. That piece is missing because it leaves you a precondition. Allah says, Allah is extremely merciful. Allah is extremely forgiving. And He will allow you to fall in love with Him so long as you understand how to follow the prophetic tradition. If that piece is missing, then there is no deal. That's what it basically translates. What does this mean to you and I? What does this mean to you and I today? Each time that you go to the grocery store and you read the labels to find out, see if there's any, make sure the ingredients are okay, you're following the prophetic tradition. Each time that you say that you're going to start your work at 8 a.m. and you're going to finish at 5 p.m. and you're actually working at 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. without taking unnecessary time off, without knowing your manager won't, you're following the prophetic tradition. Each time that you are smiling to your brother and sister, you're following the prophetic tradition. Each time that you're actually inviting someone willingly out of love of brotherhood and sisterhood, you are following the prophetic tradition. Each time that you ask this khati out to lunch, you're following the prophetic tradition. That is what it means. My younger brothers and sisters, I had a discussion with my young brother. I had a little during Yaleed, you gave money, right? As a gift. Parents, uncles, aunts gave money. I had a discussion about the same topic. Okay, now we have $200 at your hand. What is is it that you're going to do with $200? The young man said, this is my money. I'll do what I want to. I said, how do you know? It is your money. What is it that you're going to do? He said, I'm going to buy myself 5 skins on Fortnite. Those of you who don't know what Fortnite is, one of those addiction these kids are in. 5 skins. I'm going to spend $25, $30 each. I'm like, you can do that. But what else can you do? It's my money. I want what I want to do. Say, okay, let's discuss this. You could put the person down, pick it down, or you can discuss. Here is the options I gave him. Syrian refugee crisis. You have $200, alhamdulillah. You can give $10 to that. He shook his head, I can. He said, your dad is putting money for a college fund. If you have $10 in a college fund right now, in 5 years that you're going to graduate, that could be $1,000. I was making up some numbers. He's like, could be done. I said, you have a little sister. You could give $5 to your sister saying, hey, sister, how do you pay Mubarak? I can do that. I said, MCC is having fundraising. You know that. You go there all the time. There's another fundraising over there. You can give $5, $10 to that, can't you? I can do that. You can buy some food for yourself. You can buy the latest designer jeans for yourself. I can do that. You can do that. These are all avenues you can spend your money. It is a prophetic tradition that brings you closer to this idea that Allah is talking about. And Allah was further. So you could claim, you could say, brother, sounds good, theoretically makes sense, following Allah takes time. I understand it takes time. We're not denying. Allah is already answering that. Before you even think about it, the next ayah, Allah is answering. But let me say something else before I read the next ayah. Faith does not enter into the heart unless there is love in the heart. Love cannot happen unless there is loyalty and respect to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you say love takes long and Allah says this, the next ayah, قُلْ say, أَتِيَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. Let me read this again to you. Pay attention to each word, even if you don't understand Arabic. Pay attention. قُلْ say, أَتِيَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولُ فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. Say, obey Allah, and the translation says obey Allah and the Prophet. Here's an alternate translation I'm going to offer to you. This wow. This wow is an atbayan. Sorry to be geeky. That means in English, that is to say. When you give an example, say that is to say. Obey Allah, that is to say, obey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That means the equivalent. That means obeying Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is obeying Allah. That's what Allah is trying to tell you. Willingly, lovingly. And here's the kicker. Here's what gives me goosebumps. My hair and body sticks out. The next part of the ayah. In Tawanda, if you turn away from that, that means if you turn away from prophetic tradition, guess what happens? But in Allah, la yahdul kafirin. Without a doubt, Allah is saying you, without a doubt, Allah does not love disbelievers. I'm like, what just happened? What just happened? What happened is this. If you and I turn away from prophetic tradition, if you and I do not make time and effort, and you and I do not sacrifice, we do not give our status away, we are clinging to our titles, Allah says you are not among the believers because you're running away from the tradition that Allah has put forward for you. The ayat I recited today from Ali Imran, 31 and 32. Go home and read it, the translation I offer to you. It's telling you in a nutshell, obey Allah, listen to Allah, listen to His book, to His message, and that is equivalent to doing what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in His tradition. أَقُولَ قَوْلِي صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَحِيمٍ. Jerusalem. Bring it home. Each time we talk about this ayat of Quran, bring it home and look at your own things, daily activities, routines, what you do. And say, how does that fit to me? How does this ayat fit to me? Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said his mission, one of his missions, is to تَمِّلَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ or كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. One of his missions is to perfect, to complete, to beautify our character. So pay attention. Character is everything that you and I do. Pay attention. Do we give our due rights to our kids? You have son, daughter. Do we give our due rights to them? Do we spend time with them or we are harsh with them? Or we are only authoritative to them? Our spouses, do we give our rights to our spouses? Are we nice and lovingly talking to them? Ittaqullah wa qulul qawlan sadida, Allah says, be mindful of Allah and to your spouse, your family, speak with a loving language. Qulul qawlan sadida. Do we do that? If for some reason we have been separated, divorce took place, you know that's the hardest part. That is the hardest part. All the anger, all the aggression, everything comes out at that time. Are we still in that state to really give it back to him, give it back to her, or we are being just? Or are we being just? These are all the things that embed in this area. If you and I are doing anything, when tawallu means when we turn away from all these things, when we take someone's right away, you're turning away from this. In the Allah and ayat we have read is the title that we inherit. In Allah says something about that. Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهُ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقيموا الصلاة